Hello everyone. Again, welcome back to my channel. So today's class we try to discuss another topic on nonlinear dynamics. If you have seen my previous lecture, in that lecture we try to discuss the basic idea of what is a dynamical system and what is system of equation, what is linear system of equation, how you can draw the phase portrait. Of course, a phase portrait, every phase portrait you cannot draw using hand, you have to use some programming or some software. So then we have discussed what is vector field. So today's class we discuss the basic idea about the fixed point. So when we discuss about vector field, there we have discussed something about fixed point. So today's class we discuss something about that. So let's start. So there are two kind of system. One is called autonomous system, another is called non-autonomous system. So what is autonomous system? In autonomous system, the right hand side, the dependent independent variable will not be there explicitly. For example, if I give say dx dt equals to ax plus by and dy dt equals to cx plus dy, this is a system. This will be autonomous system because here the dependent variables are x and y and independent variables is t. You see, in the right hand side there is no function of t is present. I mean, no function of t directly is present. Okay, so basically if something, so this is one autonomous function, autonomous system. So in general we can say that a system dx dt and dy dt, this will be autonomous system if the right hand side will be only a function of x and y, that is no t should be present directly. So it will be a function of so when we write this kind of system, so clearly we can understand this will be one autonomous system because in the right hand side it is a function of x and y, no t is present there. So in this context we try to write the autonomous function in this way. Okay, so let's start. So if we consider this autonomous system and suppose I am do the solution of this, say p x y equals to 0 and q x y equals to 0. So after solving, suppose we are getting x naught y naught. So what we are doing, we are making this p x y equals to 0, q x y equals to 0, and we are solving this. So when we are solving these two equations, we'll be getting some solution. Say the solution is x naught y naught. You may get more than one solution, you can get one solution also. So that will be depending on the right hand side, what is p and what is q. So this is called critical point. Or sometimes this is called equilibrium point. So why it is calling like this? You see, when p x y is 0 and q x y is 0. So by the way, x naught y naught is the solution of this. That means at the point x naught y naught, p should be 0. So that is p x naught y naught will be 0 and q x naught y naught will be 0. That is x naught y naught will satisfy this equation as well as this equation. That is the meaning of solution. So that means at x naught y naught, so what is pxy, dx dt, so dy dt. So that means at x naught y naught, dx dt equals to 0 and dy dt equals to also 0. Now commonly you think, what does the mean of derivative? The derivative means it is the growth. Okay, so dx dt means it is the growth of x with respect to t, dy dt means it is the growth of y with respect to t. So basically when we write this 0, that means the growth of x with respect to t is 0, the growth of y with respect to t is 0. So it feels that the system will be in a, in a stable kind of position or in a silent position. Okay, so that's why it is called equilibrium point. For example, I have given this example very often. So if you throw a stone in a pond, in a calm pond, so at which point you throw the stone, some wave should be there, and after some time the wave will disappear. So when the wave will be there, that means the water is growing and decaying, grow and decay. So when the wave will be less and it is almost zero or eventually zero, that means the growth will be zero. So that kind of point where the growth is zero, that is called equilibrium point. So here it is equilibrium point. Okay, so if I give a simple equation, say one question like this, say dx dt equals to x plus y and dy dt equals to y. So if I have to find equilibrium point from there, so what I have to do? So basically I have to solve. So if I have to find critical point or equilibrium point, so critical or equilibrium point, what I have to do? I have to make x plus y equals to 0 and y equals to 0. So we have to solve this. So y equals to 0, if you put there, you get x equals to 0. So the solution is x equals to 0, y equals to 0. So this is one critical point or equilibrium point. So you understand? So basically when we have to find critical point or equilibrium point, that means basically we have to solve some system of equation. Okay, so that we can do using our normal algebra. Next, if I give another example, say dx dt equals to y and dy dt equals to sin x. So if I have to solve this, that means I have to basically solve. So for critical point, I have to make y equals to 0 and sin x equals to 0. So y equals to 0 means it is nothing but y equals to 0, and sin x equals to 0 means x equals to n pi, where n is 0 plus minus 1 and so on. So that means here we get infinite number of equilibrium points. What are the points? The points are n pi 0, where n equals to 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 and so on. So like this we can find equilibrium point. So when some system will be there, you may get a unique equilibrium point like this first problem. So here only 0 0 is the single equilibrium point, and when there may be some problem where there are infinite number of equilibrium points. So here one example is this. So the first equilibrium point is 0, 0. Then it is pi, 0, 2 pi, 0, 3 pi, 0. Similarly, minus pi, 0, minus 2 pi, 0, and so on. Now, why should we study equilibrium point? Why the equilibrium point study is important? The point is that, suppose the origin is equilibrium point. Okay, carefully you try to understand. And we have started a curve from a nearby point of this one. That is, we draw a neighborhood, and within the neighborhood, we've taken an arbitrary point and we have drawn the curve. So when the curve will be drawn, so what does that mean? That means basically, say dx dt equals to p x y and dy dt equals to qxy. So if we can draw the vector field, so basically we'll be getting dy dx equals to q by p, and we can solve, so we can get the equation of a curve. Okay, so this curve, say we have started from any arbitrary point, so if the curve is going and approaching to the equilibrium point, then we can say this system is stable. So this is one. So basically the autonomous system one is stable if we, so whatever definition I am giving, that is not mathematical definition, that is some idea that what is stability. If we taken a starting point, within a neighborhood of equilibrium point E, then the solution curve approaches to E. So it, the solution curve will get closer to E. That does not mean it will touch E. It will be like the limiting position. It will be tending towards the point. Okay. So what is an example is that? So the basic idea is that what is stability in day-to-day life? The stability means, suppose this is a duster, it is stable. What we are doing, if you are giving some push, it is again coming back to the original position. So that is the meaning of stability. But if I take the duster in this way, if you give a push, it will fall down. So here the meaning is that this is the equilibrium point. If we take a slight bit push and this point we choose, then eventually it will come back to the original point. That is the meaning of stability. Now, there is another thing is there. So here the stability we have told, so here few points are there, that it approaches towards E. So the curve approaches, so this is the starting point basically. You can take some other starting point also. Number two, if the curve touches E, so if the curve actually touches the point E, then also it is stable, then the stability is called asymptotically stable. So what is the difference between asymptotically stable and normal stability? In the normal stability means it will coming towards the equilibrium point, but asymptotically stable means it will actually come to the equilibrium point. Okay, so this is some of the difference. Both are stable, but asymptotically stable is much more stronger in nature. Now these are the things which is theoretical. But how can you solve that some system is stable around the equilibrium point? So what we can understand, if we have to show some stability, that means we need to know the equilibrium point. Then only we can take some point and we can do the stability. So for any system of equation or any system of linear system of differential equation, you need to know the equilibrium point in the beginning, then we can discuss the stability. Now this is a theoretical approach, but how to find stability actually? So let me give the stepwise procedure, so it will be helpful probably. So what will be given to you? So given to you will be a system, say dx dt equals to pxy, dy dt equals to qxy. And what you need to do? checking the stability. So what will be step one? So step one will be, so this is if I take one, so find equilibrium point of one. So your first job will be you have to find the equilibrium point, okay? Step two, the next step is very important. Find Jacobian. What is the Jacobian means? The Jacobian is denoted like this. Those who know multivariable calculus, this is very easy for you. Those who don't know multivariable calculus, so I am giving you the idea. What is the meaning of Jacobian? So Jacobian of PQ, PQ with respect to X and Y. With respect to X and Y. So Jacobian of the function with respect to X and Y. This has another notation. You can write del PQ del XY. So what is the Jacobian? This is a matrix. How, what will be the elements of the matrix? See, first it is P. So it is like PX, PY. So like del P, del X, del P, del Y. Then Q. So del Q, del X, del Q, del Y. So what you have to do? You have to find the Jacobian. Step three. Now this is a 2x2 matrix. For our case, if there are three equations and three variables, then it will be a 3x3 matrix. Okay? Then we have to find the eigenvalue. Eigenvalue. How to find the eigenvalue? So we can take del P del X minus lambda del P del Y del Q del X del Q del Y minus lambda. So here we can, by solving, we can get lambda equals to lambda 1 and lambda 2. Now the stability means if lambda is negative and real, then it is stable around E. E means equilibrium point. Say E. And this Jacobian also you have to calculate with respect to E only. Okay? So stable. Now if lambda are complex, it may happen that when you calculate this, the root may be complex. So if these are complex, so complex means lambda will be alpha plus minus I beta in this form. So lambda 1 may be alpha plus I beta, lambda 2 may be alpha minus I beta. Then also it implies stable. That means if the roots are complex, then if the real part of the root is less than 0, then it will be stable. Number 3, if this is not happening, suppose we have got 1 lambda positive, 1 lambda negative. So both are not negative. So otherwise, otherwise it will be unstable. Understand? So what is the meaning of stability and unstability? Is this in general. Now it may happen that this alpha is zero or something, so that type of exceptional case we'll be discussing in next few lectures. So today's class we are basically giving the broader view of stability analysis, how you can calculate the stability. So let's try one problem, then only it will be clear. Okay, so let me write So just we are erasing this one. So say the equation is this, dx dt equals to x plus 3y and dy dt equals to 3x plus y. Okay, now what will be the first job? So this is the system is given. So this is our equation number one. The first job is that, so to do stability, so this step is okay, this step is okay. The first job is that you have to find the equilibrium point of one. Equilibrium point means, so equilibrium point means x plus 3y equals to 0 and 3x plus y equals to 0. So we have to solve this. So if we solve, basically we get x equals to 0, y equals to 0. Only one equilibrium point, okay? So this is also we have done. Then find the Jacobian. So what is the Jacobian? Jacobian will be, so this is actually your P and this is your Q. So del P del X, that is 1, del P del Y, 3, this is 3, this is 1. And what will be the eigenvalue? If I take this, eigenvalue minus lambda, minus lambda. So this will be basically if I take the determinant and if I take the characteristic equation, so eigenvalue, it will be 1 minus lambda square minus 9 equals to 0. Okay, so here we are getting 1 minus lambda square equals to 9. So that is 1 minus lambda equals to plus minus 3. So 1 minus lambda equals to 3, so lambda equals to minus 2, and 1 minus lambda equals to minus 3, so lambda equals to 4. So in this system we have the equilibrium point 0, 0. So around the equilibrium point we calculate the Jacobian, and finally we have got two lambda values, one is negative, another is positive. Hence, this is not a stable equilibrium point. So 0, 0 is not a stable equilibrium point for this system. So that's all for this class. So today's class, we try to discuss the procedure of finding the stability. And today we try to discuss what is equilibrium point, how you can find the stability and all these things along with some example. Thank you.